I get those goosebumps every time. for the visitors from Elizabethtown High School, coached by Mr. Todd Boudin. Sophomore number one, Chloe Wilkinson. Senior number four, Maggie Kaiser. Senior number 12, Annabelle Price. Senior number 14, Jane Lloyd. Senior number 24, Emily Williams. And now for the Golden Mules of Solanco High School, coached by Mr. Brian Kern. Sophomore forward number 10, Manny Wang. Senior guard number 12, Josie Jackson. Junior forward number 23, junior guard number 32, Abby Lane. Freshman center number 42, Saskia Ludgate. Your officials for tonight are Mr. Bleacher, Mr. Bennett, and Mr. Miller. Good luck to both teams.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Solanco High School. I'm Zach Snyder alongside Levi Palmer as we're set to bring you Section 2 action tonight as the Elizabethtown Bears take on the Golden Mules of Solanco. Opening tip belongs to the Bears as they get their offense underway here. Clouser handles. She gets it here to Wilkinson. Wilkinson takes a dribble and back to Clouser. Clouser drives, first shot of the game is no good. Rebound fought over and eventually controlled by Abby Landis for the Mules. Jansen takes it the other way, leaves it here for Cut. And Cut back to Jansen, inside to Ludgate under the basket. Ludgate shot, no good. Then we've got a foul there committed by Ludgate as she fouls Emily Williams after she hauled in that defensive rebound. Clouds are here for the Bears. Back to Wilkinson. Wilkinson finds Williams here in the corner. Tries to get it in there. I think Jansen got a hand in there to knock that one out of bounds and prevent the offensive effort from the Bears. E-Town comes into this one with a record of 2-8 all overall, leaving them in fifth place here in Section 2. The Mules are just a game behind them with one win and eight losses to their name, sitting in sixth in Section 2. Ludgate to Cut. Here's Jansen. She's got Ludgate posted up inside, but instead tries to go cross court to Landis. Jansen to Landis. Landis back to Jansen here. Jansen finds some driving room and lays it in for the first 2 points in this one. Got a foul committed. Foul's gonna be called against Josie Jansen. That's her first. Let's go, Wolfhauser continues to run point here. Gives it to Wilkinson. Wilkinson forced three. That's no good. Offensive rebound hauled in by Williams and the Bears. Price for two, and that goes. First two of the evening for E-Town belong to Annabelle Price as she ties it at two. Inside to Ludgate. Ludgate's tied up there. Going to call a foul against Wilkinson. That's her first. Wanger set to inbound for the Mules. We've got our first substitution. Lane Dolly checks in for Solanco. She replaces Maddie Cutt. Jansen to Dolly. Dolly passes up the three. Gets it instead to Landis. Landis back to Jansen. Mules continue to be patient here on offense as they work it around the perimeter, looking for weaknesses in this E-Town defense. Trying to break down this E-Town zone they're in right now. Jansen in the corner, Jansen for three. Won't go for Josie. Rebound corralled by Williams for E-Town. Good quick feet there by Josie Jansen as she gets in the way of Clouser, who is driving for E-Town. And Josie Jansen draws the offensive foul for the Golden Mules. That turnover cedes possession back to the Mules. Dolly to Jansen. Jansen finds Ludgate. Ludgate, shot won't go, but she gets her own miss. Second attempt, no good. And then we've got a second offensive rebound here, corralled by Landis. So the ball stays right here with the Mules after those two quick offensive rebounds. Dolly in the corner. Jansen finds Landis. Dolly switches sides of the court. Now she's got in the other corner. This time she drives. Scoop layup goes for Lane Dolly. It's 2 points for the freshman after she checks into the game. And that one's picked off by Ludgate. Jansen heading the other way. She's got Landis and Dolly. Eventually makes its way to Dolly, who gets it to Landis, guarded here by Wilkinson. Mules lead by two. Halfway gone in the first. Jansen to Landis. Landis has it ripped away from Wilkinson. Don't count the steal for Wilkinson. They're going to call that a jump ball situation, but the arrow does favor E-Town. Sarah Mathias checks in for E-Town, and Coach Brubaker will take the first timeout of the game. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. Well, we've got a break in the game action. Let's take a moment to thank some of our sponsors of Solanco Athletics. CR Laps Family Restaurant, The Daily Grind in Quarryville, Berkshire Hathaway Homesale Realty, Stewart Enterprises, Dolce Vita Pizzeria and Grill, Rhodes Energy, and Susquehanna Ford. Back underway. It's Mathias to Wilkinson. Wilkinson's pull-up shot, I think it's blocked by Jansen, and then it's corralled by Ludgate. Landis tries to save it, but that's going to be out of bounds. Last touch by the Mules. Wilkinson set to inbound for the Bears. Jansen applies ball pressure.
Klauser's able to hold on to it. Klauser to Price. Price has got the only 2 points of this game for E-Town. Matthias. Here's Lloyd's shot. No good. Wanger with the rebound. Foul is committed by Sarah Matthias, who just checked in. Jansen's picked up her dribble, looking for help. Finds it inside Ludgate. She can't control that pass. Wilkinson spots Price inside, but Jansen with those quick hands again ties her up. That's going to be a jump ball. Arrow favors the Mules. Got two substitutions coming in, three substitutions coming in here for Coach Urig. Maddie Harnish and Jalen Gonzalez check in for the first time, and Maddie Cutt, who started this one, is back in for Solanco. Cut drives baseline. That's going to be a traveling violation. Loose ball. Grabbed by Maddie Harnish. Gets it to Josie Jansen. Josie slows it down here as the offense gets themselves set. Still 4-2 in favor of the Mules. 1:45 left in the first. That pass is too high for Gonzalez. It's going to be a turnover committed by Josie Jansen. Matthias' shot, no good. Maddie Harnish right there for the rebound for Solanco. Gonzalez heads up court, finds Lane Dolly. Dolly to Jansen. Gonzalez here in the corner. Back to Jansen. Jansen. Looked like she was going to drive, but it kicks the Dolly. E-Town bench was asking for a traveling violation. They don't get it. Here's Gonzalez in the corner. Gonzalez does commit a traveling violation, sending possession back to the Bears. Wilkinson's pass for Lloyd is too tall, out of bounds, back to Solanco. They've got 34 seconds with which to work here at the end of the first quarter. Jansen appears to be in no particular hurry. I wonder if the Mules might hold for one here in the waning moments of the first. Cut to Jansen. 15 seconds left in the first quarter. Jansen drives. Jansen's foul there. I think it's going to be called against number 12, Price. Mules set to inbound. 11 seconds with which to get a shot off. Jansen. Jansen inside. That's Maddie Harnish. Falls to Lane Dolly, calls for the shot to get up. Josie's got 2 seconds. She's got to shoot. She gets it off. Won't go for Josie at the buzzer. After one, the Mules have doubled up the Bears. It's 4-2. We'll be back with second quarter action in just a moment. Welcome back as second quarter action gets underway. Wilkinson pulls up. Shot won't go. Cut with the board for Solanco. Jansen's pass makes his way to Dolly, who is fouled there by Williams. First personal foul against William. First team foul against E-Town here in the second. Landis to cut, works it around here to Jansen. I think they called a 3-second violation there, an offensive 3-second violation on Solanco. That'll be a turnover, handing the ball back to E-Town. Ball's poked loose. Clouser's able to hold on to it. Lloyd to Williams. Williams shoots and scores for two. That made two-pointer from Emily Williams. Ties the game at four. Here with a minute gone in the second quarter. Dolly and Jansen work it back and forth. Here's Harnish to Landis. Back to Harnish. Quick hands there by Lloyd, result in the turnover as she pokes it away. But then E-Town returns the favor, hands it right back to the Mules. Cut sent here to inbound in front of the Solanco bench. He gets it to Jansen. Jansen to Dolly. Jansen was looking for Landis, but a little bit of miscommunication there as Abby took a step in, and Josie thought she was going to take a step out, and that resulted in the turnover. Gonzalez back in for Solanco. Josie Jansen's going to take a seat. Lloyd to Williams to Clouser here. Clouser leaves it for Williams. Gets it to Lloyd. Lloyd's going to pull up for two. Shots off the mark. Let's see what the foul is here. So Lloyd was fouled in the act of shooting. She's going to head to the line shooting two. First one's up from the senior. That one's no good. Here comes the second free throw attempt from Jaden Lloyd. That one does fall, giving the Bears their first lead in this one. It is now 5-4 in favor of E-Town. It's a traveling violation committed by Lane Dolly. Clouser to Williams to Wilkinson. Back to Clouser. Gonzalez almost got her hand in there to poke that one away. Clouser shoots for three. No good. Long rebound. Good hustle there by Abby Landis to secure it for the Mules. Landis to Gonzalez inside to cut. Ball ends up loose. And And then Clouser had it for a second, but she wasn't able to control either, and it's going to stay right here with Solanco. Maddie Wanger back into the game, replacing Maddie Cut. Landis for two, off the glass, good for Abby Landis. Mules regain the lead, it's now 6-5 Solanco. Clouser to Wilkinson. Wilkinson guarded here by Gonzalez. Clouser thinks about it, leaves it for Wilkinson. Wilkinson shoots 4-2 and knocks it down. First 2 points in this one for Chloe Wilkinson. Maddie Wanger inside finds Ludgate. Ludgate's shot won't fall. Williams right there for the Bears. Williams shoots 4-3, no good. Ludgate for Solanco. Here's Lane Dolly to Gonzalez. Inside, they left Abby Landis alone. Shot's no good, but she is fouled there by Price. It's gonna set Abby Landis the line to shoot two. Abby's hit 4 of her 12 free throws on the season. Knocks this one down, tying us up at 7. Morris has entered for the first time for E-Town. Here's the second one from Landis. That one's no good, but Ludgate pulls in the offensive rebound. Her follow-up effort, and here she goes again. Still won't go, but she gets another offensive rebound. Third shot, still no good, but she is fouled and is going to head to the line. Slank is going to shoot two more. Both coaches have substitutes ready at the scorer's table to check in here between the two free throws from Ludgate. First one from Saskia Ludgate is good. Matthias checks in for E-Town, replacing Lloyd, and for Solanco, it's Jansen back in this room in place of Lane Dolly. Second one from Ludgate is good as well. Mules now lead by 2. It's 9-7. Clouser to Wilkinson inside. That's Morris, who just checked in, who's fouled. She's fouled from behind by Ludgate. Matthias for Clouser. Clouser shoots for 3. That one comes up short. Matthias with the board gets it there to Morris. Morris shot, no good. Congested on the inside, but Maddie Wanger controls, and then a good outlet pass finds Josie Jansen. Breaks the other way with speed, leaves it back for Maddie Wanger. Here's Gonzalez. Back to Jansen. The Mules are going to slow it down and get fully set here. Landis and Jansen back and forth. Wanger to Gonzalez. Inside, she's looking for Ludgate. It looked like it might have gone off the shin of Wilkinson. Ends up in the backcourt, but last touch by a Bear, so that's not going to be a backcourt violation. Gonzalez is going to shoot for 3. Doesn't go. That one looked like it was close. Last touch there by Clouser and the Bears. So possession stays right here with the Mules. Lane Dolly's back into this one after a short break on the bench. She replaces Gonzalez. Landis set to inbound. Looking for a teammate. Finds Lane Dolly. Dolly thinks about the shot and instead gets it back to Landis. Mules looking to space the floor here. Ludgate sets a screen for Jansen. There's a quick jump ball call, but the arrow is going to favor Solanco. One. Lloyd's back in for E-Town, replacing Matthias.
Dolly to Jansen. Jansen here to Landis. Dolly's going to shoot for three. That's going to be short from Dolly.
Going to have another quick jump ball situation. This time the arrow is back in favor of E-Town.
Got another substitution. Cut's going to replace Landis.
Mule pressure almost results in a turnover, but Klaus is able to turn the corner. Leaves it here. Lloyd's going to shoot for three. That one was halfway down. Doesn't go. But who is that? That looks like it's Morris that got the offensive rebound. She goes right back up with it, makes the basket, and is fouled heading the line.
Foul was committed by Maddie Cut. Jillian Morris looking to make it a three-point play, and she does convert, giving the lead back to E-Town.
Close one with 2 minutes left here in the second half, the second quarter. Mules trail by one. It's 9-10. Cut shoots 4-2. That one is no good. E-Town's trying to push. They find Morris. Morris's layup won't go.
Last touch by Ludgate as nobody was able to control that offensive rebound.
Williams to Wilkinson. Inside, Lloyd shoots for two.
Maddie Cut with the board for the Mules. Here's Lane Dolly.
Inside Ludgate, back to Jansen. Jansen drives, has her pocket picked there by Lloyd. Klauser spins, leaves it for Wilkinson. Coach Brubaker from the E-Town bench calls for them to hold it, slow it down here. 30 seconds left in the first half. Morris guarded by Wanger, inside to Lloyd. Lloyd's shot, no good. Ludgate quickly gets it to Jansen. Jansen back to Ludgate. Ludgate, here's Dolly. Dolly fakes the shot, gets it to Maddie Cut. Here's Josie Jansen. Good ball move by the Mules. Jansen's fouled on her layup attempt, and Josie Jansen will head to the line, looking to give the Mules the lead here with 8 seconds left in the first half.
First one bounces around but will not fall for Josie.
Here comes the second. This one's good. Josie knocks it down to tie us up at 10. E-Town's got 5 seconds to get off the shot. Here's Wilkinson in the corner. Wild shot. No good. Williams gets the offensive rebound, and hers will not fall as well. So after one, we are all square in Solanco. Mules 10, Bears 10. We'll be back with second half action in just a moment. Welcome back as we get this tie game going here in the second half. Opening possession belongs to the Mules. Dolly here in the corner. Inside to Ludgate. Ludgate to Wanger. Wanger's shot, no good. Lloyd grabs that rebound. Wilkinson and the Bears here in their first offensive possession in the second half. Here's Clouser back to Wilkinson. Inside Price. Price's shot is blocked by Ludgate. Lloyd grabs the rebound after the black shot. Here's Price. Lloyd, and Lloyd commits the traveling violation as she tries to step around Ludgate and get that shot off. Wanger to Jansen as the Mules try to break this deadlock. Get some points on the board for the first time in the second half. Jansen to Landis. Dolly in the corner. Landis and Jansen working back and forth. Dolly cuts. She finds some room. Not able to get the shot off. Jansen. They're going to call another 3-second offensive violation on Ludgate. That turnover gives the ball back to the Bears. Minute and a half gone here in the third quarter. Still no scoring from either side. Landis fouls Wilkinson as she reaches in. That's going to be the second personal foul against Landis. First team foul against the Mules here in the third quarter. Wilkinson finds a cutting Price. Price lays in 4-2. That's a nicely designed set play off the inbound for the Bears. Coach Urig takes a full timeout as the Mules prepare to talk it over. After the timeout, it'll be Solanco ball as they face this 2-point deficit here in the third quarter. Dolly to Jansen. Jansen from the screen from Wanger leaves it for Dolly. Dolly shoots for three. Won't go for lane. Dolly, Josie Jansen right there for the offensive rebound. Her shot's no good. Lloyd for the Bears as Clouser heads the other way. Williams, Price in the post against Wanger. Price's shot, nice quick hands by Wanger to block that one and control it. Here's Dolly. Dolly drives through. That was Price that got in the way there at the last second to prevent what would have been an easy layup for Lane Dolly. Gonzalez is at the scorer's table here for the Mules. Shot from Lloyd. Sits on the rim, but does not fall for the Bear. Langer in the post. That entry pass is denied there by Lloyd. Here's Williams. Williams shoots 4-3. That one doesn't find anything. Loose ball there involves a collision. Landis got there first, but both players are down on the play. We're back underway after that collision between Abby Landis and Clouser for the Bears. Both players have returned to the bench, shaking off, I think it looks like, head bruises. Here's Dolly in the corner. She gets it to Gonzalez. Inside looking for Ludgate. That's off the foot of a Bear defender. I believe Williams kicked that one. Dolly in the corner. Dolly pulls up for two. Won't go. Lloyd controls the rebound. That looked like that might have been a travel, but they didn't call it. That's going to lead to a layup for Price. Dolly under the hoop. She was closed quickly there by Morris and Lloyd. Possession of the Bears. Here's Wilkinson. Wilkinson to Williams. Here's Price. Price shot from two, no good. Jansen with the board for the Mules. Jansen drives, layup, sits up there, won't fall. Ludgate with the offensive rebound. We've got a holding foul here called. It's going to be against E-Town. Let's see who it's called against. Fouls committed by number 12, Price. A little bit of confusion. Solanco tried to go quick there. Referees were on the same page. Do not count that three from Josie Jansen. Substitutions up and ready. Maddie Cut in replacing Maddie Wanger. Mules trail by four, 2:46 left here in the third. Inbound goes to Lane Dolly. Dolly's shot. She's fouled on the way up. So Lane Dolly's going to head to the line shooting two. That foul was committed by number 24, Williams. That's her second. First from Dolly is long, will not go. Second in and out. After Morris pulled in that rebound, she's fouled by Maddie Cut. Cut almost had the steal, but eventually makes his way through to Price. Price holds that back pivot foot, finds Morris. Shot won't go for Morris. Gonzalez with the rebound for Solanco. She heads out of the way. She's got Josie behind her. A little bit of contact there. It's last touch by Gonzalez. Wilkinson breaks through. She finds Morris. Morris can't control that pass. Here goes Gonzalez again. Josie trailing her. And she's fouled there by Lloyd. That's going to be the third team foul committed here in the third quarter against E-Town. We've got a 30-second timeout taken by Coach Brubaker and the Bears. Lane Dolly set to inbound here for the Mules. She gets it to Josie Jansen. Jansen dribbles it by Wilkinson. Gets it to Dolly in the corner. Dolly back to Jansen. Jansen to Gonzalez. Gonzalez trying to find cut inside. That pass is tipped by Wilkinson. Lloyd eventually controls that loose ball for the Bears. Wilkinson, wild shot, does not go. Williams with the offensive rebound. Here's Gonzalez. By Jansen, nice look. Jansen! Layup's good, and she's going to head to the line for one more. Jensen hit one out of two free throws from the line in the second quarter. This one, no good. But Ludgate's there for the offensive rebound. It ends up in a jump ball situation. Arrow points E-Town's way. Mules still trail by two, 1:25 left in the third. Jansen almost stole that one away. Not able to hold on after she got there. Now E-Town will inbound from the corner. Mules applying pressure. Wilkinson and the Bears break through it. Wilkinson behind the back. Here's Price. Price gets guarded by Gonzalez. Back to Wilkinson. Williams. Dolly pokes that pass on its way through to Lloyd. Lloyd's shot is too heavy. Gonzalez, I think her pass was intended for Lane Dolly. Last touched by a Bear defender. Possession will stay right here with the Mules. Cut to Gonzalez. Gonzalez to Dolly. Back to Gonzalez. And then Dolly. Gonzalez is tied up there by Wilkinson. Arrow still points the Mules way. We've got a timeout taken by Coach Jurg. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. Seconds left in the third. Mules trail by two. Our score is 12-14. Jansen to Dolly. Dolly tries to find Ludgate inside. That entry pass is denied there by Lloyd. Here's Price for the Bears, but Price can't hold that back pivot foot this time and commits the traveling violation. Jansen for Solanco, fakes the drive, back out, cross court to Gonzalez. Gonzalez to Dolly, here's Jansen with a little bit of room. Jansen for cut, Jansen for three. That one's gonna hit the top of the backboard. Price set to inbound for the Bears. She finds Williams. She's being traced by Dolly. Williams shot. No good. The referees are going to have a discussion here about who touched that last. Initial signal was in favor of Solanke, but I think they're going to reverse that call. the signal was still towards Solanco, but they're going to give the ball back to E-Town. Jansen and Wilkinson fight over that inbounded ball. Results in a jump ball situation. It's going to be Solanco's possession. They've got 3.7 seconds with which to work here at the end of the first. A little bit of confusion there with the arrow. I think it was not changed after the last jump ball. They are ruling that it's going to stay with E-Town, so the arrow was wrong. It should have been E-Town's ball. Lloyd, shot's no good, and that will bring us to the end of the third quarter. Our score is Solanco 12, E-Town 14. We've got ourselves a two-point game as we head to the fourth quarter. Welcome back into Solanco High School. As we start the fourth quarter, we've got ourselves a good one as the Mules face a two-point deficit here in the final frame. Gonzalez to cut. Back to Gonzalez. Here's Jansen. Mules working it around. Dolly now in the corner, back to Jansen. They're going to call a double foul here. So let's see who these fouls are called on. First one's being called on Wanger. And then the second one, I believe, is being called on number 13. That's Morris. Got a substitution then for E-Town after the double foul. Thias is checked back in. Here's Jansen to Gonzalez, back to Dolly in the corner. Dolly's gonna shoot for three, no good. Lloyd, she's been tough on the board all night as she gets another one for the Bears. Here's Lloyd inside, she's fouled by Maddie Wanger. That's two quick personal fouls Maddie Wanger picks up here to start the fourth quarter. That'll be the third personal foul against Maddie Wanger. Second team foul. Ooh, Maddie cut almost had the steal. Then it's poked away by Gonzalez. Poked away again by Gonzalez, but the Bears still able to hold on. Wilkinson drives, layup won't go. Lloyd, like I said a moment ago, she's been a killer on the boards and she gets another one. It's another jump ball situation. Arrows back in favor of the Bears. Abby Landis has checked back in for Solanco after she was down on the court a few moments ago. That's a deep two made by Williams. Dolly inside, gets her shot up. Won't go. Gonzalez applies a little bit of pressure here as Wilkinson tries to bring the ball up. Wilkinson's pass for Lloyd. Lloyd's shot attempt is no good. She's fouled on the way up, so Lloyd is going to head to the line, shooting two for the Bears. Lloyd knocks down the first. She's up to 2 points in this one, both coming from the charity stripe. Second one from Lloyd is no good. Maddie Wanger fights for the rebound. Josie Jansen tries to bring it in, but that one bounces off her shin out of bounds. Mules face a 5-point deficit, 6:27 left here in the fourth. Price for two. Won't go, but Lloyd tips it back in bounds to Williams. Bears maintain possession. Wilkinson's runner's no good. Lloyd once again with another rebound for E-Town. Gonzalez tried to get this steal, but she was too close to the sideline. Bears scored off of this similar inbound play in the third quarter. Traveling violation committed by Wilkinson. Gonzalez's pass is too high for Landis. Bears were able to break the pressure. Lloyd shot, no good. Abby Landis back into the game, gets the rebound for Solanco. Landis' shot, no good. Dully pressures Wilkinson. Wilkinson spins, gets it to Williams. Williams shoots for three. Williams' three is off the mark. And then Matthias is fouled on the inside. Fouls committed by Maddie Wanger. That is her fourth. Lloyd shot attempts, no good. Matthias with the rebound. Long rebound attempt after that second missed shot. Is controlled in the backcourt there by the Bears. Williams to Matthias. Matthias lays in for two. Timeout taken by Solanco. Our score is Solanco 12, E-Town 19. Thank you. Jansen here for the Mules. Gets to the Landis. Dolly in the corner. Dolly's going to shoot for three. Won't go from lane. Dolly. Offensive rebound by Josie Jansen. She's then fouled by number 33, Matthias. Second personal foul against Matthias. Second team foul against the Bears here in the fourth. Not a shooting foul, so possession just stays here with the Mules. Landis looks to Dolly. Back to Landis. Mules got to get something going here on the offensive end. Shot from Landis. No good. Another offensive rebound brought in by Jansen. Her shot off the mark. This time it's Maddie Wanger for the Mules. Wanger's fouled there. I think it's going to be called against number 24, Williams, but we'll have to see. Foul's actually called against number 14, Lloyd. Dolly looking for Ludgate, but the pass is intercepted by Wilkinson. Price to Williams, back to Wilkinson. Here's Lloyd, Wilkinson, and Williams. Bears working around. So we got 3:45 left in the final quarter. Floater for no good from Wilkinson. They're going to say, I believe Wilkinson made contact while she was out of bounds. So I'll give the ball back to the Mules. Mules' offense has been held to only 2 points here in the second half. Jansen has it stolen away as she tries to drive. There's Wilkinson. Floater won't go. Wanger gets it for the Mules, and then she's fouled by Wilkinson. We've got a full timeout taken by Coach Brubaker and the Bears. We'll be back with the conclusion of this one in just a moment. Wanger inbounds here to Jansen. Mules picked up their first W of the season last week as they got a win against Penn Manor in the Coach McDowell Holiday Tournament. That's going to be a foul committed by Maddie Wanger, and that's her fifth as she starts to walk towards the scorer's table. So Maddie Wanger has fouled out of this one. She's going to take a seat on the bench, replaced by Jalen Gonzalez. Morris, first shot is no good. Second one does fall there for Jillian Morris. Jillian Morris is up to 4 on the night, making her the co-leading scorer for E-Town. Josie Jansen is the leading scorer for Solanco. She's got 5. Bears by 8, 2:13 left. Williams kicks at the ball to deny the entry pass to Ludgate. Mules offense has really struggled to break down this Bears defense in the second half. They've only managed 2 points, and both of those came from the free throw line. We've got a timeout called by Coach Urich. It's going to be a full timeout. 1:50 left in the fourth. Solanco 12, E-Town 20. That one's off the foot of Wilkinson. We'll try it again as Dolly prepares to inbound to Jansen. That one's stolen away. Price got it for the Bears. Wilkinson to Williams. And then Williams is fouled by Lane Dolly. That's going to send Williams to the line. She's going to shoot 2, as that's the 5th team foul. It's going to be 4th team foul committed by Solanco. That one's long from Emily Williams. Here comes the second. That's no good as well, but here's been the story of tonight. Lloyd pulls in another rebound for E-Town. Morris drives by Ludgate. Layup's no good. And we're going to walk the floor here, as that's going to be the 5th team foul committed by E-Town. That's going to send Abby Landis the line, who's shoot 2 for Solanco. First one from Abby's no good.
Thank you.
comes the second from Landis. That's short. Morris got the rebound. Mules applying pressure. Etan will break it here. Then I imagine just slow it down as they look to kill the final minute of clock here in Quarryville on this Thursday night. Mules, Bears look like they're going to secure their third win of the season. Landis. Rebound's no good. Here's Dolly. Dolly to Gonzalez. Gonzalez for three. And that one's good from Jalen Gonzalez. Pulls the Mules back to within five. We've got a timeout taken by Solanco. 28 seconds left. Looks like Gonzalez's toe was on the line for that last shot, so count that as two, not three. Got a foul committed by Solanco. It's going to be called on Gonzalez. That's her second. Solanco willingly sends the Bears the line. Shot's good from Price. Ludgate's in replacing Cut. Here's the second one from Price. And that one's good as well. Mules trail by eight, 20 seconds left. Gonzalez to Dolly. And Dolly commits the traveling violation. We've got a full timeout taken by E-Town. Our score is Solanco 14, E-Town 22, with 11.6 seconds left in the fourth. Bears look to run out the clock as the Mules apply pressure. Wilkinson to Price, Price to Morris, and that will do it. Our final here in Quarryville is Solanco 14, E-Town 22. Thanks for joining us.